According to legend, the Chitimacha are the original inhabitants of what we now know as South Louisiana.
We were a peaceful tribe. We were fishermen. We lived off the waterways, so it was peaceful village life. Everything we needed was here.
Everything to make a good life off of the land. And at the museum, there's definitive proof of their existence several centuries ago.
It's a chunky stone, and it dates back to the 1300s. We do have our traditional dugout, which we have mounted here, which dates to the 1600s.
One of Fonseca's favorite things about the museum are the school field trips.
Interacting and engaging where I let them touch things and I teach them parts of our language. And so the cutest thing for me is usually when they leave, I have, 40 fourth graders going, Nito, Nito, telling me bye. And I just, that's the highlight of every tour.
At first, when Europeans settled, they lived side by side. Unfortunately, those good times didn't last.
Slaving raids took place against Chitimacha villages. So at one point in Louisiana history, the Chitimacha were the most enslaved of any group.
And the problems continued into the 20th century.
Locals wanted our land. Our people were poisoned. They were shot. There was many atrocities that happened in the early 1900s. Children were sent to Carlisle Indian or Industrial School. The mission of Carlisle School was to strip basically the Indian out of the person and save, quote unquote, save the man. We acknowledge that part of our history, but we don't let it hold us back. We know more today about our history than I think we ever did. And certainly the language is being passed on to children, and that's going to carry us for generations.
And preserving the language is an understatement.
It went from wax cylinder to cassette tape. And all the written notes were digitized as well.
And now it's available to all tribal members.
We have developed our language on Rosetta Stone software.
It's now been taught in the tribal school for 20 years. Today, they thrive with their own constitution and tribal government.
The tribe operates with a five-man council, which consists of a chairman, vice chairman, secretary treasurer, and two council members.
And another first.
Our current chairman is Miss Melissa Darden, who is our first elected female chairman of the tribe.
And the message you should leave with from the museum?
Humble beginnings and adversity are not reasons to just give up. And through commitment to self and tribe and perseverance makes us stronger. And we are a small tribe, but we're still here and we're thriving.
For Acadiana's News Channel, I'm Dave Baker.